Okay, everyone, welcome back to Joe Man's Land. I hope you're having an amazing day. Today's video is going to be all about how to get drone-like footage in cityscapes where you can't actually fly. I recently purchased an Osmo Pocket 2, which I'm going to be sticking on this giant stick. What? What do you want?
Yeah. She's coming out to catch some rays and tell you the big news.
Okay, well, it's sunset, so there's that. And I'm gonna regret this, but what's the big news?
The channel just hit a big landmark for subscribers.
We had like 80 last week. What's the landmark you're talking about?
Like, we can get real sponsors now. Like, I'm talking, like, no more Circle Space, Squarespace, and like, no more SoundCloud, Artlist. Like, that'd be awesome. And oh my God, no more Lego blocks, we can get story blocks.
What number did we reach?
We can like even roll some hype footage, like this.
Bring that ass back like a boom, boom, boom.
That's brutal. Show me the number.
Yeah. Okay, fine. Not really. There we go. Still a landmark.
100.
Oh, dude, Jesus. All right, now that I've lost 4 subscribers from that horrible intro, finally outlining how I broke 100 subscribers, it's time to get into the meat and potatoes of what we're doing today. We are making fake drone shots in downtown Calgary using a free boom pole I got off Kijiji with an action camera, which I also got off Kijiji, because if you can't tell already, we like Kijiji. So we're gonna just stick this on here. Ideally, I would have bought a cell phone mount to put on the bottom so I can actually see what I'm doing, because I got the creator combo with my Osmo Action 2, which includes a wireless sending module, which allows you to see on your phone what you are doing. But we don't have that. We're gonna put it in FPV mode as well as follow mode and just stick this thing up in the air and see what we can get. The biggest thing is we are following all the rules because we aren't flying a drone. I'm just a crazy person with a stick. I feel like Gandalf. None shall pass. Okay, so now we're using whatever the built-in microphone is on this, and we're gonna create the ultimate selfie stick. So one of the things you guys might have realized is a lot of my videos, Tony doesn't want to be in it, is actually shot here. And this is the Calgary Tower Parkade. It's on the 8th floor here, just off 9th Avenue. Great spot to go. Just when you come in, just be mindful. It is a parkade. It's not a place for people to do Instagram photos and set up for like a 3-hour photo shoot. But if you're just doing a quick little bit, it can be really good. I've come here numerous times with Marcus, now Tony. Tony's not a photographer, but even Tony thought it was a good view. Right, Tony?
Absolutely.
Great view. Great view. Yeah, good spot to come. But yeah, now we're vlogging through the Osmo Action, Osmo Pocket. I don't have an Osmo Action. I don't know why I'm saying those things. But yeah, this is just the inside. Obviously, this camera does not do as well when we're indoors. But here's kind of a neat view of the train that goes through. So we are on our way to the dollar store because after all, it is time to go out and Frankenstein this techno crane. So I think this might be like the biggest dollar store I've ever been in, but we have come to our amazing location of whatever electronics they've got. It's all right here. So whatever we get, it's gonna have to be usable.
with these things.
And I got this weird thing called a max charge flexible light phone holder. Just look at that amazing piece of ingenuity. So it's got three colors: warm, neutral, cool. None of that matters. We're gonna rip the light off it, actually. So basically what we're trying to do is, you know, obviously we've got our first few pieces of the techno crane, which is obviously the camera as well as the stick. And then we're gonna be basically trying to fasten, let me get in my pocket, my phone onto the stick. So let's get into the unboxing of the $3 max charge. Okay, as you can tell by that unceremonious unboxing, I am planning on this working and not returning this $3 item. So let's get into it. We've got our amazing phone clamp, which of course we are gonna need to actually hold the phone. Make sure that goes wide enough. I think that's probably the first thing we should probably check. And yep, it just fits. So from a clamp perspective, from a phone clamp perspective, this will work just fine. Really all I need is the clamp to fasten to this, which then fastens to the actual phone piece. That's the most important element of what we're trying to accomplish here. So hopefully we are able to do that with this piece of ingenuity. So I guess we'll leave the video there. I definitely say that my jib did not work. The $4 mount I got kept dropping my phone and that didn't work out. Then the sun went away and of course, like I said, using the Osmo Pocket 2 when in bad lighting conditions is not a good idea. We're standing on a freeway and that's a perfect place to also lose subscribers. Hit that like button, please. Subscribe to the channel. I look forward to seeing y'all in the next one. Remember to take beautiful photos every single day. Don't do it for the views, do it for yourself. And I promise I'll be back soon with an improved jib and a better review of how to use the Osmo Pocket 2 in a sort of drone-like scenario. And I think that that's a big thing as well. On this channel, I like to share my failures and successes. And while this wasn't a total failure, I definitely wouldn't say it was a total success as well. Anyways, folks, see you in the next one.